Well, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all for coming. My name is Jonathan Himes, and I'm ecstatic to be officiating the wedding for two of my very best friends, Brad and Kirsten. I'm so thankful you guys could come here on to this beautiful location and also on this beautiful, beautiful day. I'm looking out into the audience right now, and I see so many familiar faces, so many people that I've just met, some that I don't know yet, but the one thing that I do know is that each and every one of you is special to this couple, and you guys have in some way, shape, or form been responsible for molding these two people that are very, very special to me. So I want to thank you. But I also would like to challenge you guys to continue that love and that support as they take this important next step in their life. Now, a lot of times at a wedding, the officiant turns to the couple and tries to give them advice on like the trials and the joys of marriage and that kind of stuff. Well, I'm not gonna do that because I have had a front row seat to this entire relationship that I feel like, and if there's any couple that I think understands what the big step of marriage is, it's Brad and Kirsten. From the moment that Brad was calling me and telling me about this really cool girl that he met at the front desk that he bought pie for and that he really, really liked, to finding out that I guess Kirsten liked him too because she went all the way to Oklahoma to go visit him, I knew that they were going to be a good couple. And I've watched them go through so many things, merging their dog families together, buying a house, moving to Marshall, taking over a family business, that kind of stuff. And all throughout it, they've always approached each other with love and support. They've always put each other first, which is really, really, really important. I've watched them take joy in each other in both the big things like going on vacations and game nights and that kind of stuff, but also just the day-to-day things. And they've always met each other with love, and it's truly an honor to be here today and to bring these two couples, this couple together. I would like to mark this special occasion with a poem that, if you know Brad and Kirsten, which you all do, I feel like is very, very much them. They're both dog people, as you saw, they brought it into the wedding. And as soon as I met Brad, I immediately met Brooke. She sat on my feet, made me pet her. Met Nova right after meeting Kirsten. Now, every time I go over to their place, I get to play with Nash and, don't tell the other dogs, but my favorite, Neela. And so I just wanted to highlight this wedding with this poem. So it's by a poet named Taylor Molly, and it's called "Falling in Love is Like Owning a Dog." And I hopefully you guys get something out of it like I did. So falling in love is like owning a dog. First of all, it's a big responsibility. So think long and hard before deciding on love. On the other hand, love gives you a sense of security. When you're walking down the street late at night and you have a leash on love, ain't no one gonna mess with you. On cold winter nights, love is warm. It lies between you and lives and breathes and makes funny noises. Love wakes you up all hours of the night with its needs. It needs to be fed so it will grow and stay healthy. Love doesn't like being left alone for long, but come home and love is always happy to see you. It may break a few things accidentally in its passion for life, but you can never be mad at love for too long. Is love good all the time? No. Sometimes love makes messes. Love leaves little surprises here and there. Love needs cleaning up after. Sometimes you just want to get love fixed. But sometimes love just wants to go for a nice long walk because love loves exercise. It runs you around the block and leaves you panting. It pulls you in several different directions at once or winds around and around you until you're all wound up and cannot move. Throw things away and love will bring them back again and again and again. But most of all, love needs love, lots of it. And in return, love loves you and never stops. So I hope that meant something to you because I immediately saw it and I thought of you two. And I hope you guys out in the crowd, you can, at least can find some kind of line or something like that that resonated with you. I've been doing most of the talking, so let's turn this over to Brad and Kirsten. They both prepared their vows, and knowing the two of them, we know they're going to be very well thought out, very passionate, and very full of heart. So Brad, if you'd like to go first.
I wish I could stand up here and promise you the world, but the world isn't mine to give. However, what I do promise to give you is my world, and all that it entails. I vow my honesty, I vow my trust, I vow my effort, and I vow my love. I will be there for you and to love you every day. Through all our successes and failures, I will always choose you.
That's wonderful.
It's too good.
Kirsten?
I promise to love you even on the darkest of days and toughest of storms. I promise to never let our sense of adventure fade as our days pass. I promise to be your confidant, share all your heavy burdens with. I promise to stand by your side while you face this world. I promise to grow alongside you, but never also grow up. I promise to love, respect, protect, and trust you, and to give you the best of myself, for I know that together we will build a life far better than either of us could imagine alone.
That was truly beautiful. Garrett, if you could come up with the rings. Brad, do you take this woman to be your wife?
I do.
Kirsten, do you take this man to be your husband?
I do.
Then I'm pleased to announce that for the first time ever, Brad and Kirsten are man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
It's mine.